Let's now tell you about the state of affairs in China. Now, China's position as the world's factory hub is under threat, with intense backlash over its response to COVID-19. Foreign manufacturers are now making a beeline for the door. And experts believe that China's loss could very well be India's gain. But Beijing is not giving up without a fight, and it is deploying state-run media houses to build a counter-narrative against India. The Global Times has called India's efforts to replace China as self-righteous. The article claims that India is in no position to attract multinational companies because of its inadequate infrastructure and strict foreign investment regulations. Now, interestingly, the Global Times offers no data or evidence to back these arguments. And this propaganda push shows that Beijing is indeed wary of losing ground to India. The COVID-19 pandemic has exposed the drawbacks of a China-centric industrial supply chain. As China locked down its provinces, the global supply chain froze. And the uncertainty was compounded by China's guarded approach in releasing any information about this virus, eager to not repeat its mistake. Now companies are drawing up plans to exit China, and India stands to gain from this exodus. Reports indicate that as many as 1,000 foreign companies have expressed a keen interest in shifting their manufacturing bases to India. Discussions are underway with Indian authorities. A couple of days back, German shoemaker Casa Evers announced that its relocation to India is a big possibility. And the company produces more than 3 million units annually and will make an initial investment of around 110 crore rupees. Union Minister Nitin Gadkari recently called China's weak position a blessing in disguise for India. The central government had already slashed corporate taxes in September in India, and now it is readying a massive pool of land to attract outgoing investors from China. Archaic labor laws are also being reworked in India as we speak. Uttar Pradesh in India has formed an economic task force to attract foreign companies. The Global Times has called this move delusional. But the task force seems to be producing results already. The German shoemaker that we just told you about is in fact opening its plant in Uttar Pradesh. The Global Times also calls the United States trade policy against India punitive. While the trade relations have soared since Donald Trump took office, recent developments have bolstered India and US ties. In fact, New Delhi's decision to export hydroxychloroquine to the US was well received by the US president. On the other hand, US and China ties have absolutely plummeted. President Trump has flat out accused China of spreading the virus, and the much anticipated trade deal between the two countries now hangs in the balance. There is also talk of the US-China trade war resuming post the pandemic. India also seems like a better bet from a geopolitical standpoint. New Delhi took the lead in bringing together SAARC nations and G20 members to collectively fight COVID-19. In contrast, China has antagonized trading partners like Australia with threats and insults.